Professor Manzi, who will speak at the Chicago Chairs.
So thank you very much. I'm very happy to be here at this conference. It's an honor to Pepe. I know him since 81. So we meet in Alcata. At the moment we just both of us finished the PhD and we have a very interesting discussion, not only mathematics. Okay, so this is a resume of the talk. I will talk about Jacobian parts and the Jacobian conjecture. Then I will explain the local part, the critical of the Lyapunov chairs. Then the main one is common critical of Jacobian pairs, the main formula. And well, I should say that the part two is a joint work with Abianca, who is already a pair in the American Journal of Mathematics. And our main motivation was to, in the geometric study of the Jacobian conjecture, distinguish well between global and local argument. Because the motivation was a very interesting example of Orekov. Orekov proved an example of a surface, proving that you cannot prove the Jacobian conjecture just arguing locally, even not only locally, arguing locally in a neighborhood of infinity. So that was a surface with a P1 embedded with self-intersection 1, like the line at infinity, in such a way that the Jacobian is just concentrated there. So the main thing is just how to distinguish a local and global part. In fact, I remember, so this was the motto of this, I remember one talk of Orekov with a very provocative title, saying what you should know before you give a geometric proof of the Jacobian conjecture. That means you should understand his example. So that was my main motivation. And I said, the main technique is a Newton polygon, and we will make a geometric interpretation of the condition of the Newton polygon. And the main formula is this one, the integral of the Euler characteristic of the fibers against the Euler characteristic is equal to 1. And we'll see this definitely is a global, has a global part. So sometimes in the proof of, in the geometric proof of the Jacobian conjecture, even if you have in account the Orekov examples, it's difficult to see if something is, sometimes it's easy, but sometimes it's not easy to see what if something is local or not. So it's very subtle, okay? And well, so we will have this formula, from this formula, we'll see how to prove the, in some unknown cases, the Jacobian conjecture. In order to not rise the expectation, I should say that I will not prove the Jacobian conjecture again. Make it is clear. Okay? So that's it. So this relation with the, what is that? Everyone knows what is the Jacobian conjecture in the plane. You have a couple of polynomials. We assume only that the characteristic is zero. And we call a Jacobian pair, Fg, is a couple of polynomials as the Jacobian is constant, but it's not an automorph. So in all the, when I say Jacobian pair, means a pair of polynomial with a constant Jacobian and not an automorph. And of course, we will make some geometric properties of Jacobian pair. And of course, the end of the game is just prove at the end that there is not such a pair. That's the Jacobian object. Okay? So we consider the pair, and mainly we will study the fibers of the polynomial. Okay? And what are in common the fibers of the polynomial, I call it Ct and Ds. Okay? It's well known that by Abianca and another, that in this situation, by change of coordinates, one can assume that the fiber has to point at infinity, that we can assume the P1 and P2. And And also there is many, many more conditions on the little part. And I just resume all the necessary conditions in this theorem, and that is due to many people, Bianca, Mo, and all. So they say that if it's for a Jacobian pair, then the Newton polygons, the global Newton polygons, are proportional. In fact, the degree are proportional, and with a proportion PQ that are greater than 1. And that means that the Newton polygon of F is P times a primitive polygon delta 0, and the same for Newton polygon of G. And this delta 0 is like this. So it's contained in 1 square. We will call the horizontal, say the long edge, A is bigger than B, and the vertical short edge. We will see the geometric behavior in these two points are different. Okay, so this is the setting. And that we are going to the local theorem. So, as I said, we try to prove that distinguish what is local and what is global. The first thing that we did with Bianca is just proving that all the things that they were used for the Jacobian conjecture and infinity are related with the critical and local. So you can prove it for polynomial, but you can prove it for local. In fact, the second is just, you don't need, we say meromorphic germs, but it's completely algebraic. In fact, working with Bianca, trying to explain something to Bianca, then the complex numbers are forbidden. So you have to be, everything is algebraic. So we consider germs of course, when you take a polynomial and localize infinity, you get something like f, big F over set D. So localizing, we get what we call a special germ. So a special germ is a germ of a meromorphic function of the form h over x to the d. Okay? And then this gives you, for instance, you are in the algebraic setting, you can only evaluate at the 7. But that means that you can evaluate f, h and x, and if both of them are local in the maximal ideal, then it's not defined. You know, it's not well defined. And it's well known that the method you can resolve in determinacy by blowing it. So that's considered the succession of blowing up pi and the composition we call is delta 2 there. This is the that means that in this result map, the gamma is well defined in the sessional divisor. Okay? And one sessional divisor is called critical if they map to the bit by one. Other people call it the horizontal divisor. Okay? And the main theorem of our work saying was that in this special case of special germs, I mean the denominator is just the power of a variable, then this map restricted to the critical divisor is a polynomial. That means it's a rational function with one pole. And then to this polynomial, each critical we associate two numbers. One DE will be the degree of this map, and then nu E will be the augmented canonical exponent. So it's the exponent of the Jacobian of the map plus one. So it's called augmented canonical exponent because it's the exponent of the so-called augmented canonical device. Okay, so we have the main invariant is nu E B. Then we can compute from the Newton polygon this of of F and the successive Newton polygon that we get when we found the roots of F as a power series in X1 to E, we can compute the critical divisor and the decimal. In fact, the main point is that in one of these successive Newton polygon, we say that an edge is the critical in the special monomial corresponding to T is just in the boundary of the edge. Well, we shall say, as explained there, that when we make this transformation, we don't want the T to disappear. And the trick for that is just consider a new variable. So, otherwise, for some values of T, we'll just change the volume in the polygon. So, alternatively, it's very easy, just consider all this in the ring with coefficient K of T, K or algebraic closure of K of T. So that means, as I said, the critical divisor corresponds to the critical edge. And so usually, the other possibility is that this special point is just so just is behind the Newton. As I say, there is one-to-one correspondence, okay? And then, and from the Newton polygon, you get these two numbers. Then, now we go back to Jacobian packs. So, what can say now about the critical division of Jacobian packs? Okay, so in this case, we will say that they have a lot of critical divisor in common. In this case, we get the critical divisor just performing the Newton-Poisson methods. In this case, for the Newton-Poisson methods, for the polynomial f minus t, okay, the t is a variable. That means that we are just going to the in the Newton polygon to the left. That means that we study the roots in this x one minus one to the a. Okay, but this is similar to the algebraic case. Okay, and the main point here is that remember that the Newton polygons are proportional, and the main point is that when you do Newton-Poisson, also the Newton polygons are proportional up to a certain point. So this is well known. I mean, it was, for instance, in a paper of Parusinski, and this is the main technical point. So what we're going to do is just how to interpret this geometrically, this fact, the fact that the Newton polygon are proportional at two certain point. So that's the main, okay? And we will go, the critical divisor of the... So, then, so we consider the divisor of the, in the resolution, okay? And we call common divisor of the pair. That's the divisor of the resolution that are common for both polynomial and are terminal. Terminal means that following the resolution, the some sense the resolution of f and y just split. That's what means. I mean, at some moment, at the next step, they are not going by the same place. And then we have two kinds of common divisor that we call DD of E. The most important part is just the common divisor that are the critical for F at G. Okay? And then the non-common divisor, so that means here, the one here to the right. So that means that they are the critical for F, and the branches of F, passing with some direction, they are the Kitka 4G, okay? And the other common divisor are like that. Then the function are not resolved, but the resolution of F and G are going for through different points. So that's the main. Of course, there is a third possibility, is that a divisor that is the critical for one and not the critical for the other. But we will see the main. We will see that this is not this doesn't happen. Okay. So this here. Okay. So then the first theorem say that for you have a Jacobian pair, then for all commonly critical, the degree is actually bigger than one. In fact, is for if the critical, the degree is of F at least the critical is a proper P, multiple of P, and the degree of G is the same multiple of Q. Okay. Then, for as I said before, the common non-critical are non-critical for both of them. Okay. And then in the the third result is that remember the short edge, the one in the short edge, all the divisors are commonly critical. Okay, so and a first last result was essentially is Pierre-Lacassou guess that is they have also a common divisor that is non-critical. So it's not possible to have all the common divisor to be all of them critical. So at least there is one that is not critical. In fact, what we have proved is that, of course, if there is no non-critical common divisor, then the geometric degree has to be set. The geometric degree is, we call it D, is the degree of the map, the topological degree of the map FG. Okay? So that means that you need at least one non-common critical, and in fact, there is a formula, so I give a formula for computing the geometric degree from the edges of the, for the slopes of the non-critical devices, or for the slope of the edges of the Newton polygon corresponding to the non-critical device. So you can compute that. I did not write the formula because I need some preliminaries, I will need at least half a page. But there is this formula. Okay, so now you can, we are, you can put all this information in a tree. Okay, so this is essentially the Asimov diagram tree, it's an algebraic version of the Asimov diagram tree. So, because you need a tree because what you have is a Newton polygon, like the one to the left. From each edge of the Newton polygon, you make the corresponding Chebyshev variable, and you get a new Newton polygon. Each edge gives you a new Newton polygon. So what you have is a nested series of Newton polygons, and then you can as this one line, you can put this in a tree. Saying for each Newton polygon, you write a vertical line. For each edge, you put one point, and in the point you put the slope or cross slope of the edge. So this is corresponded to the first Newton polygon. You have lambda 1, lambda 2, lambda 3. Then you make one of these Newton change, and you get a new Newton polygon, and you do again the same. Okay, this essentially is the EN diagram. And then, as I say, we finish. We only stop when the last divisor or the last edge in which they are gone. So I write something like this: a black box when they have a common critical, and we put here the invariant mu and v. All of this can be deduced from lambda. And when they are when a common divisor is not the critical rule, we put like something like that. F and G, arrows meaning that the resolution of F and G is still going somewhere, so you are not that fixed. Okay, and then, okay, so now we wanted to remember our goal is to use some global condition. Then what we are going to do is just following the geometric interpretation of this fact that they have a proportional polynomials, I mean, is to compute the earlier characteristic of the factor. So there are more geometric interpretation. For instance, from this fact you can see when you consider extend the map FG, which divisor are going to infinity, which divisor are going to the finite part, etc. But you will just stay with it. So we consider the Euler characteristic of any fiber, we call CT. But anyway, you don't need topology to do that. So as I said, that was for Bayer when talking with Javier. And then we can consider the early characteristic of the generic fiber. I call it CG. Remember, the generic fiber is there is a known result that there is a finite set called the bifurcation set of the bifurcation values of F are the values such that the early characteristic of the fiber is different than the only characteristic of the generic fiber. So these are called the bifurcations. And then there is a result by Hall, Lea, and other in higher dimension that say that you can compute the only characteristic of the generic fiber in this formula. 1 plus mu I is the mu, the affine part. In our case, it will be 7, because you have a Jacobian pair has no critical point at the finder. And then lambda infinity is just the difference of the minimum number of infinity of the finder. So this is the first formula. And also, you can compute the Euler characteristic of any fiber, just like the Euler characteristic of the generic fiber plus the lambda, the sum of the lambda at the singular point of infinity, okay? Plus mu affine that in this case would not. Okay? So then the first result that we get is that for the Euler characteristic you have a Jacobian pair. So the only characteristic of the generic fiber is D minus the sum of the common critical of the new I. Yeah. Okay? So you see that the only characteristic of the... D is the geometric degree. So you have Fg, and that means as a polynomial from K2 to K2, and it's the cardinal of the generic fiber. So the number of inverse image of a generic point of K, okay? We call it the degree of the math fiber. Okay, so as I say, big D is computed from the non-critical common divisor, and D and E are computed from the critical common divisor. So you see, so far this formula, that is, as far as I know, is new, is a local. So then we go to the global. So, but it's clear here that one is local. And here is the global part. The thing is that from the data of Jacobian pair, it's possible to compute the Euler characteristic of the generic fiber But it's not only it's not possible, but it's not possible to compute what are the special files. So this is not, you have not enough information. But what gives this formula is that you cannot compute the only characteristic of one file, but then you can compute the only characteristic, the sum of the only characteristic. Well, then this is what to compute with the integral of the only characteristic. Remember that definition of the integral of the only characteristic of any function, you decompose the base in strata in which the function is constant, and then you multiply the value of the cost of the function by the Euler characteristic of the strata. In this case, that means that this integral is just the Euler characteristic of the generic fiber times the Euler characteristic of the open, which you have the non-typical values, and then you add the Euler characteristic of the and then, so this is now this is the formula. What is new here, so our first command is that you see the degree of the critical division had disappeared, but it appeared this very strange invariant. But I will comment more about that. This invariant is for each divisor, you consider F, E, G are the local equation in this divisor, and you consider the values of phi for which the derivatives are a common root. And then at this point you consider the intersection of this. Okay? Let me if I can write something here. So this is the E, in some sense. And that means that for some special value, you have a singular point for F and singular point for G. And the sum of intersection multiplicity, this is what is this IE. Okay? And this is already a global argument. In fact, everything is local. But what is global is saying that all this is equal to the Euler integration of the Euler characteristic of the fibers is equal to the Euler characteristic of the total space, that is K2, that is 1. So the global part of the equality is that 1 is equal to D minus etc. etc. Okay? And now, alright, and this is new, and in fact, going back. Alright, so in fact, I will illustrate this with one important example. I mean, and what is the meaning? Applying this method, these local methods, the Newton polygon, etc., many authors, Moll, Heitman, Soladek, Balky, arrived at, so we're able to make prove that some cases do not happen, and the first case in which they were not able to prove that they do not exist, well, this case in which the degrees are 48, 64, PQ are 3 and 4, and this is the primitive Newton. And what happened is that, I will explain in this format, what happens is that in different flavors, but all of them just get all the necessary condition that you get from the polygon. But what will happen is that there is a fourth condition that is not in the polygon. So let's say it's deep in the polygon. Sorry. So there is some fourth condition that is deep in the polygon. And for instance, Heyman said, well, there is more condition, but the only thing I can say is that this condition gives you more equation than bios, but it cannot prove. And what I wanted to stress is that, this subtle part is what is here. This subtle part is just measured by this intersection multiplicity. Okay? So, going back to, the example of GCD of the degrees in 16, in this case, the, degree, I mean, for the local condition, this can be computed. The, geometric degree is 9. The, aumented canonical exponent is 2. So the formula gives 1 equal to 9 minus 2 minus I. And that means that I is equal to 6. So that's the, what and then because of the local situation, it's very easy to see that the condition I equal to C and nu equal to 2, they are not, they are contradictory. I mean, nu equal to 2 means that at this divisor, the, Jacobian is just x to, to the 1. And x to the 1 and EI equal to 6 is a contradiction. So really, this proves the Jacobian part do not exist. And this is essentially new. And also, following the same idea, one can prove that there is only one common critical. You have the same situation. By the way, in this case, the, tree is very easy. You have the two points at infinity. One is the, common critical, and the other point is just the non-common divisor. Well, then what is next? You go back to the formula. At, so you see that here disappear the, degree of di. So just and at this when I get the formula, I was hoping that maybe when you just iterate the, Jacobian iterate the, Jacobian the pairs, so then the degree is just going up. I was hoping that I will get a contradiction. In fact, the next thing is just prove that, computing, is it possible to compute the tree of, the Jacobian, the tree of common the critical of a composition. For instance, you can get, if you have Jacobian bar, the tree of the, from the tree of phi, you can get the tree of phi squared, etc., etc. And just that you can compute. But in fact, you get the new formulas, but they are consistent with the, first one. So you get the tree, you get the new I, etc., etc., but you get essentially non-new condition. So, and, at this point, so I did this computation of the tree of the composition, and then I make a mistake in computing some of the new. So at some moment I was thinking that I have a proof of the Jacobian conjecture. Then I said to some friends, but then as the sun condition, so the method is correct, but it was some mistake in the computation of the new I. But okay, so what is next? You see, we get a lot of necessary condition for the Jacobian pair, even a very nice formula, but it's a little frustrating because you never see one Jacobian pair. That means that this nice formula, if you want to check it, I mean, maybe it's a formula from the void, so that's somehow frustrated. You cannot check this one. So I hope that this formula, the integral, is right, but I have no way to check in any single example. So that's, but one good thing is that, in fact, this is the end, the last slide, is that one can prove one can give put the same formula for pairs that in which the Jacobian is not 1 but just x to the e. So in fact, for many people thought that this with polynomial you will not get that kind of it's very difficult to get this kind of pairs in which the Jacobian is just 1 monomial. But in fact, there are examples. So this is a very nice example constructed by Balki from Lima and Michone and Michone. This is one of them. And this second polynomial is very, very is huge. But at the end, these two are already polynomials, and the Jacobian is 2. So really, as I said, you have the same formula. The only thing is that in this case, the vertical line is also you have to treat it like a decrease, because you have Jacobian and vertical line. And then, of course, in this case, you can check in this example that the formula of the integral is correct. So, and I hope that maybe composing with this polynomial, I can get some contradiction that gives you Jacobian conjecture. But that's my hope, and I don't know, we'll keep to inform. And that's all. So, gracias and muchas felicidades, don José.
Questions? Yeah. Back on page 11, you said you could compute the whole thing for powers of a given Jacobian pair.
Yes.
So what if you had two different Jacobian pairs that were different automorphisms in the semigroup they generate? Can you compose two of them?
Yes, you can compose, and you can get the tree of the composition.
So would there be any hope of, if not proving the Jacobian?
Yes, there is some hope. That is not finished. That means that maybe you can prove that you get a contradiction that if you have a Jacobian pair, you have only one.
Yes.
If you have two, then you get a contradiction. But I did not finish that. I did not. But maybe, yes, maybe this happened. What I just proved is that composing one for instance, automorphism, all is automorphism, you get nothing. So that's.
More questions? Well, so if not, let's thank the speaker again.